If I look back over my, you know, at this point, 30-year career, you know, the changes have been unbelievable.
When we started, there wasn't even a classification system for fractures.
I was the first woman in the orthopedics. I was the second woman surgeon in the university system.
We have been a leader in the country in regards to increasing diversity by gender.
I think we populated the state with quality orthopedic care.
The expansion of the ability to get orthopedic care, particularly in the small communities around Minnesota, has been tremendous.
As I look back on research and progress in orthopedics, and I try to look forward and ask the question, what is the role of the department in contributing value to partnerships that is aligned with scholarly work and new ideas? I end up focusing on innovation. Because really, innovation in care delivery and care quality is what our partners are interested in. And going back to our land grant mission, it's what we should strive to provide in those partnerships to add value. We have three major partners. They're of equal size in terms of the surgeries and the patients that we see. A third of our work is within the Fairview Health System, roughly. That's mainly at the university campus. A third of our work is at Regents Hospital and now the TRIA Orthopedic Center in Woodbury through Health Partners. And a third of our work is at the TRIA Orthopedic Center in Bloomington and Methodist Hospital, which is part of the legacy Park Nicollet Health System.
I think one of the neat things about the department is that there has always been this sort of town-gown combination with the university and with practitioners out in the community. So that connection, I think, between the community and the university teaching faculty was always strong. In the broader picture, in the Midwest, I mean, this is one of the premier academic institutions in the Midwest.
When you look at the town-gown relationship, the physicians that work in private practice have been incredibly instrumental in educating residents and supporting the university, the VA hospital, the children's hospital.
It may be second nature to some, but the biggest way we've impacted care delivery is training good residents.
The multiple sites for our residency program is, for some people, challenging, but I think overall is a huge plus and a benefit for our residents. I think it makes us more nimble. It trains our residents to be adaptable to different health systems and ways of doing things.
Through the training grant that's been here for many, many years, we've been able to bring in pre-doc, post-doc, as well as involving the residents in some of the studies, and I think that's really been key to having a formalized education program that brings people from all the different sites.
The University of Minnesota provides a unique opportunity to be trained in orthopedic surgery. We attract medical students from the Midwest and beyond because of the diverse subspecialty training that we get and the excellent faculty that we have in multiple disciplines. We have a very strong track record for placing our residents both in private practice in small town rural areas throughout the Midwest, as well as excelling in very prominent fellowships in all subspecialty areas across the United States.
So we train people in all of the subdisciplines of orthopedics, but we also are training people that go on to be academicians, basic scientists, work in government, work in hometowns, work in big towns, and that's what I think is our greatest legacy.
In addition, I think we have been a leader in systems education and working with health systems to provide better ways to deliver musculoskeletal care.
We were trained here, we taught here, or both, and we love the place.
Here in Minnesota, it's been an exceptional partnership, and I've been happy to be a part of that.
It's a supremely high quality group of people. And that means we were very good at selecting good people, and we probably gave them a decent education. And I would be most proud of that.
You know, in the 50 years, if you ask the question, what is our legacy, I think that I would think of a couple things. First and foremost is excellence in clinical care and an expectation and an execution on that promise to our patients. The second would be our really dominant contribution in education, which has impacted really across the world, and of course, specifically in the Midwest. We would also, I think, be recognized as really committed to the core mission. And despite essentially a continuous change culture now in medicine, and despite all the changes over the last 50 years, we've stayed true to the mission of the university, focusing on serving the citizens of the state, providing top-notch education, and advancing care through innovative clinical work.